All right, it's National Women's Health Week, and we're talking to a doctor about the number one threat to women's health and what women need to be on the lookout for.
In your Health Watch this morning, it is National Women's Health Week, and when you hear women's health, you likely think about breast or ovarian cancer risks or other gynecological issues, but in fact, the number one threat to women's health is heart disease, and that should be top of mind. Dr. Sharon Thompson of the Central Phoenix Obstetrics and Gynecology Center is here to tell us more about the number one killer of women, and after all of these years, why that message still doesn't seem to be resonating.
Yeah, only 54% of women realize that heart disease is the number one killer for women. And I think it has to do with the effectiveness, the appropriate effectiveness of breast cancer awareness. Mm-hmm. So that's top of mind for us. But heart disease really is our number one health threat.
And the statistics are fairly significant, right? One in every 31 women?
One in every three women is affected by heart disease.
Three?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, in terms of heart disease, in terms of mortality.
Okay.
One in three women die from heart disease.
We want to talk about some of the common symptoms so that you would know that you're having a heart attack. And those
Absolutely.
Are the same both for men and women in this
yeah,
case.
The classic symptom of a heart attack is that crushing pressure on your chest.
Okay.
And men and women both get that. But women can get symptoms that are not so common in men. Extreme fatigue, nausea, pain in the jaw or arm. Those are more common in women than in men.
What would the jaw have to do with the heart?
It's complicated the way that our nerves are connected. So some of the nerves that go to your heart also go to your neck and your jaw.
Okay, so I want to put that up as well so that we can kind of take a look and digest that a little bit for some of those risk factors of women.
Sure.
Heartburn, I mean, can let you know that there's a lot of things going wrong, but
Definitely.
How do you know a common case of heartburn versus something very severe?
And it is hard to tell. Part of what can help you is knowing your own history.
Okay.
So knowing your family history, knowing your risk factors, is your blood pressure normal? Is it high? Do you have diabetes? Those are sorts of things that can help you distinguish symptoms that for you and me may be benign, but for someone with that history may be more serious and cause you to go see your doctor.
And when we talk about heart disease and the risk that it puts on your overall health, are we talking just about putting you at risk for a heart attack, or what other risk factors elevate with
that? That's an excellent question. So the same risk factors that can cause you to have a heart attack can cause you to have a stroke as well.
Oh, okay.
And in fact, in the medical field, we think of heart attacks and strokes as a similar type of disease because it affects your vessels in your heart.
So what about prevention? What can we be doing to make sure that we are minimizing our risk of heart disease?
Prevention is key because many of the factors that can lead to heart disease are modifiable.
Okay.
So one, know your family history, so important. And if you have issues in your family like high blood pressure, diabetes, you want to make sure that you talk to your doctor about those things.
Mm-hmm.
Exercise. Exercise is free and easy, but many of us don't do it enough.
Right.
Take your blood pressure medicine if you need it.
Okay.
Watch your diet. So those healthy fats, staying away from the sugars, getting enough vegetables, which I have to focus on too, are key things that we can do to decrease our risk for heart disease.
And also getting tested for diabetes, that
Absolutely.
Is a big factor. It's all connected, right?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Diabetes is a big risk factor for heart attack and stroke, so you definitely want to talk to your doctor and get tested.
Do you have any direct advice, just as we wrap up, for a woman who's seeing her doctor and wants to make sure that their medical professional is making sure that they are in good cardiovascular health?
Raise the issue.
Okay.
Talk about it. What's my risk, doctor? What do you think? How do you think heart disease will affect me, given my family history, given what you know about my health?
All right.
Ask the questions.
Ask the questions. Thank you so much. It's so great
You're
to
welcome.
See you. How do
Thanks
people get in touch
me.
With you?
I'm at Central Phoenix OBGYN. We have a website, centralphoenixobgyn.com.
Thank you. Scott?